Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. This is part 19 of my course, The Practical Guide to Mac Security. This course is brought to you thanks to my great Patreon supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon to find out more and join us. So Touch ID is a feature that you get on newer MacBook Pros and MacBook Airs. It allows you to unlock your computer by just using your fingerprint. Now you may think that this sounds less secure. After all, instead of having to enter your password, you can just use your fingerprint. And perhaps there's some way to more easily get around a fingerprint lock than a password lock. But there's several reasons why it's not. First, you still need your password for many things. So it doesn't replace the password. It's not instead of the password. In fact, what Touch ID really does is it unlocks the password itself. So every time you use Touch ID, it's typing the password for you. But to get access to that password, it's using your fingerprint. Also, a lot of people are worried about registering their fingerprint on their Mac, thinking that where could that fingerprint go? Is it stored by Apple? It's actually stored in a secure place on your Mac, in a secure piece of hardware. So if you were to set up Touch ID on an iPhone and Touch ID on your MacBook, notice that it doesn't pull it through iCloud or anything like that. You have to actually set it up individually for each device. It's stored just on the device and it's never sent anywhere. If you're worried about there being an error because fingerprints, while unique for everybody, can be similar and perhaps maybe the sensor isn't perfect, Apple estimates a 1 in 50,000 chance of an error, which means the chances of somebody stealing your MacBook and then being able to use the fingerprint sensor to get access, it's extremely remote. And if you think about passwords and maybe passcodes on phones, a 1 in 50,000 chance is kind of halfway between a 4- and 5- digit code on the phone, having to guess it over and over again, except that you can't guess a fingerprint. You have to either try your fingerprint or not. So it really is pretty impossible to fool the fingerprint sensor. Now note that when you use Touch ID, a password is still needed in a lot of cases. For instance, if you log out or restart, when you log back in, you have to enter your password. Also, if you haven't used your Mac in 48 hours, so it's just been sitting there asleep or off for 48 hours, then you need to use it. You can't just use the fingerprint. It has to be a password. You can't change your Touch ID using your fingerprint. You have to enter your password. Or if you want to change your password, it's also going to ask you for your password. So a lot of the highest, most secure, most sensitive things require a password, not Touch ID. If you try 5 attempts with the fingerprint, it's going to then require your password. So you can see how they're the 1 in 50,000 chance of randomly having the wrong fingerprint unlock your Mac kind of stops there, because you can't just keep guessing after 5 attempts. 5 fingerprints that are tried, it's going to lock somebody out. And you can also use Find My, as we looked at before, to lock the Mac. And at that point, it has to use a password to get in, not Touch ID. Now, here's how Touch ID helps improve security. Now, this may not affect you as an individual, but it affects Mac users in general. First, there are still a lot of Mac users that don't use an account password. They find it inconvenient. And this is a shame, because it's, of course, critical for security, as we've learned. But since Touch ID makes it so much easier to log in, it will encourage more people to use a password. Instead of having to enter the password throughout the day for many different things, you can go from day to day using Touch ID and only occasionally need to use the password. Also, it encourages longer and stronger passwords. If maybe you've set your Mac's password to be something very short, like maybe only 6 characters, maybe even a word or something that's a weak password, this may encourage you to use a longer, stronger password, knowing that you rarely have to enter it in, instead of many times a day, maybe once a day or less. So let's take a look at Touch ID. Of course, you find it in System Preferences on MacBooks that have a Touch ID. And of course, that includes the new iMacs, which have Touch ID on the keyboards. And then when you set up your Mac, you are prompted to use Touch ID and to register your fingerprint. But you could always go into System Preferences here, go to Touch ID, and then from there you can add new fingerprints and set settings here. So you see how you can even take away some of the privileges of Touch ID if you want to force a password to be used at a specific moment when different things are done. So you can kind of set the level of when Touch ID is used and when it's not used. Also, you can add more fingerprints. So if you find that sometimes you use your left index finger instead of your right index finger, you can add both of those, or you can add more of your fingers or your thumb to Touch ID. So you should definitely use Touch ID, not be afraid to use it. If you want ultimate security for your Mac, then you would just use a long, strong password and not use Touch ID. But a good compromise is to use Touch ID and then use a longer, stronger password for your Mac. So in the past you may have used an 8-character password that's easy to type. Maybe extend that to a 10 or 13-character password that's randomly generated, and then pair that with using Touch ID so you're not always typing this strong password. And that combination gives you fairly good security on your Mac while also giving you some level of convenience.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.